everybody, I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to my craft room. Before we get started, be sure that you're subscribed here, that way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. All you have to simply do is hit the subscribe button down below and it is completely free to subscribe. Now, in this video, we are going to be focusing on our WeCreat Vision laser. However, the beginning of this video is all about making your own SVG in Inkscape, and this is a great tutorial if you've been wanting to learn how to make those, because we're going to go over several of the functions in Inkscape that are super helpful, like offset, union, path, and difference, plus a few other things that are going to help you make really good SVGs. But the other thing that we're going to go over is how to make it engrave for your laser two separate pieces. So we're going to engrave the side name separate from the big K here, and it's really easy to do using Inkscape, and this will also translate really well into how to make a SVG with different colors so that you can cut different pieces of vinyl, cardstock, whatever you're using with your craft cutters like your Cricut or your Silhouette. Now, if you're interested in getting a WeCreat Vision, which I highly recommend, I really, really like it, there is a link down below that you can shop through and make sure that you use code Corinne Blackstone, and that's gonna save you $100. Even if the machine is on sale, you'll still get that additional $100 off, which is such a good savings. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to be starting in Inkscape, which is a free program where you can design your own SVGs. And this is a really fun thing to do. So I'm going to teach you how to make this really fun name keychain and how to have it engrave the different parts at different times. Because sometimes when you do engraving with your laser, it actually seems like it would be faster if you engraved the different portions of it separately so that it's not having to go as far to engrave the different parts. But I'm going to show you how to do that if that's how you want to set up your design. The first thing that we'll need to do is to, of course, start with our text. I'm going to start with the letter K. Now, I know it's really small, so I'm going to zoom in first on to my sheet, and then I am going to make this bigger. What I do is you're going to click on the letter, hold control on your keyboard, and just pull it out. The reason you're holding control on your keyboard is so that you can keep the scale of the item. If you're not holding control, the scale will change. Now, I don't wanna use this font. It's not really what I'm looking for. So I'm gonna go into my font selection, which I have a ton of fonts, and I'm gonna use the font Impact for this. Impact is just a really nice kind of blocky letter, but you use whatever you want. It doesn't have to be this font. But now what I want to do is open up another font. And in order to do that, you want to have the A selected over on the left-hand side and click anywhere on your screen. And then you're going to put in the name that you want to use. So in this case, I'm using the name Katie. And what I want to do now is just select whatever font I would like to use as my Katie name that's going to go down the side of the K. Now, I kind of want to do something that is going to be a script font, but you can just sort of go through, find whatever font you like, and use that. It doesn't have to be a script font, but that's the way I want to do it. So I'm going to scroll through and find the font that I want to use for this. I love this one. This is Black Sample. I'll link all the fonts that I'm using down below for you, but I think this one's really cute. I love all the little swirlies, and I think it's great. Now, I want to rotate it so that it's on its side, so that when we do this, the Katie is going to run up and down the back of the letter. There's a really simple way to do this, and there are tools right here. So this tool right here is the rotate selection, and you can rotate it left or right, counterclockwise or clockwise, and then you can also flip it. And we're not going to be using flip today, but we're going to go ahead and rotate this. And I rotated it counterclockwise. That way the bottom of the word is going to go against our letter. Now I'm going to change the color of our letter. It doesn't matter what color you change it to. It's going to help us see how our design is going to look. Make sure you have the selection tool in use, which is the little arrow at the very top of the screen. Go ahead and line the Katie up just a little bit so you can kind of get an idea of how big it is. And then I want you to hold control on your keyboard. And again, you're going to pull the word out until it's as big as you want it. You can do it however you want. You can make it as big as you want. You can make it take up the whole side of the word. Whatever you want it to do, it is up to you. Now, I want mine to go through the K a little bit because I want it to look like it's kind of biting out part of the K. I think this looks pretty darn cute. So from here, what we need to do is we're going to use a linked offset so that we can kind of cut out part of the K. So it's just like using offset in Design Space. Make sure you have the Katie selected, and you're going to go up to Path, and you're going to choose linked offset, which is like kind of towards the bottom. When you choose linked offset, you'll see a small little diamond. It is hard to see. Before you do anything with the diamond, I want you to do two things on your screen. First, choose any color that isn't black or red or whatever color you've chosen. And I want you to go to the right-hand side and turn off the snapping tool. And now you can pull on your diamond and you'll see that you get a little offset. Now you can make your offset as big or as small as you want. I want it kind of small because I don't want it to eat away at too much of the edge of our K. Now once you have that offset, you can click anywhere on your screen. We have to do another step here in order to change this and make it the way we want it to be. So what I want you to do is grab that selection tool again, and we're going to select the offset, hold shift on your keyboard, and select K. Go up to Path, and I want you to choose Difference. Now you'll notice that your offset is gone, but you're left with this cute little edge around the word Katie. So when we go to cut this out of our keychain, it's going to give us this really cool look. Now what we need to do is to make sure that our text is a path. And a path is what your laser or your Cricut or whatever you're using is going to follow along to either cut, engrave, score, whatever you're using it for. So let's start with the K, and all you simply have to do is select the item that you want, the text, go up to Path. You're going to click the first one, which is Object to Path. Then, because we only have one letter, all you have to do is go to Path and choose Union. Then what I want you to do is select the Katie. You're going to go to Path, Object to Path. Now for this one, we need to do one more step. We're going to go to Object, and we're going to choose Ungroup. And you'll see you have little boxes around each of your letters. Then simply go to Path and choose Union again. Really, really easy to do it that way. Now, because I want to be able to cut these or engrave them or whatever in two separate steps, they need to be two separate colors. But I still need to make an offset around both pieces. In order to accomplish that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both pieces. I'm just going to draw a big square around them. I'm going to use Control C and Control V, and that's going to give me a copy paste option. Now, with one of the designs selected, I just want to go to Path, and I'm just going to choose Union. That's going to make our design one single piece, and that's going to allow us to use the linked offset to create the offset for our keychain shape. Now, again, choose any color down here that you want. You can change it, doesn't matter, but it can help to keep them separate. Now, what I want you to do is go to Path and choose linked offset, and you'll see you have the diamond. And again, pick any random color down here at the bottom. Then pull your offset out until your offset is relatively large. I want it to be a little bit bigger because I want my keychain to be pretty sturdy. So I like to give it a little bit of a wider offset. That way it just has a little more working like space, so it's not so thin and fragile. Now, once I've got this done, what I'm going to do is click anywhere on the screen. I'm going to take my arrow and I'm going to slide this off so that you can see. Do you see how we have these holes in our offset? We don't want that because that's where the laser will cut through, and we don't want random holes. So select that blue offset that you've created. I want you to go to Path, and I want you to click Object to Path. Then I want you to click Break Apart, and you'll see that it's got all of the little holes filled in. We have one more step, which is to choose Union under Path again. So you go to Union, and now that's going to be all one single piece. So that's how it's going to cut out. Now you can line it up, but you'll notice that now it's over your other design. That's where these come in. These are our layer panels. So sending all the way to the back, sending down one layer, sending up one layer, or sending it all the way to the front. So I'm going to click this one and send this all the way to the back. And then I'm just going to get it lined up where I'm happy and where it's supposed to be. It was a little too high up where I had it, but that looks pretty good. Now we need to add a place to put our circle for our keychain. But before we do that, you can go ahead and just delete that extra one. We don't need it.
Now, I also want to size this before I put the circle in, because sometimes when you size it, your circle may end up being a little bit too small for your keychain hardware. So go ahead and select the entire design. And then up here at the top, we have sizing. We have width and height and a lock button. And then it shows your height in whatever measurements you want to use. I like to use inches, and then I'm going to go ahead and lock my design so that when I change the width or the height, it will change the opposite and it'll keep the scale. So I don't probably want my keychain any more than about 3.5 inches tall. That's usually a pretty decent size for a keychain, but you make it however big you want. It's up to you. Now that I have it sized, I need to add the little spot to put my circle or my hole to hold my design. Now you could add it to your offset if you want to as just a hole, but I like to add a little extra chunk. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a circle here, and on my screen, I'm just going to pull out a circle shape. Now, if it's not perfectly circular, hold the control button and you'll see it kind of goes oval right here. But if you just pull it regular, it stays into a whole circle. I don't care what size it is right this second. I can resize it in just a moment. Once I've made that circle, go ahead and grab that selection tool. And here's where we can size it down a bit. And I'm watching kind of the sizing up here so that I can see that it's not going to end up being too small, because I don't want it to be really thin. So I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. I'm holding control on my keyboard, and then I'm going to line it up right here. Now, don't worry. I know it's overlapping part of the Katie. That's okay. I'm fine with that. It can do that. Now what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and use Control C and Control V, which is copy paste, on my computer so that I can just make a second circle. I'm going to go ahead and just change the color of that circle. It doesn't matter. And then I want to place it back over the red circle, and I'm just going to find the little sizing area and like kind of want to size it to how big I want it. Now, because this is overlapping a little bit, I'm going to have my circle not fully centered because I want to give it a little bit of a thicker area on the outside so that it's able to hold in our design. So I can go a little bit smaller, and I'm kind of watching up here. Like, that's about half an inch, which is pretty big. So I think I can reduce the size just a little bit of both of my circles just so they're not super huge and taking up a ton of space. I think that looks pretty good as is. And like I said, I kind of want my circle to be a little closer in to my keychain. I have to do two things for this. So what I need to do, because my little circle overlaps my offset a little bit, I'm going to show you how to kind of deal with that, because you need to do a couple steps. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to grab the red circle and our teal offset, and I'm going to go to path, and I'm going to choose union. Now what you want to do is take your blue circle and your teal offset, go to path, and you want to choose difference. Now you have the spot for your hole. Now I think that does look way too big. If you're unhappy with it, just click undo, and you can definitely size this down, and you can size it however you want, but that is a little bit big. But like I said, I like to make the hole area for my keychain a little bit thicker so that the keychain doesn't break the wood or the acrylic, whatever you're doing this on. I think that looks better. So again, I'm going to select the blue and the teal, which that one I accidentally selected the K. I want the blue and the teal, and go to path, and then go to difference. That looks much better, much more even. I think that one just looks way, way better. Now we've got it sized. I'm just going to double check my sizing. It's about 3.5 by about 4 in height once I added the circle. I think that is fine. Now, again, we have three different colors because we're able to give this three different layers, and it's going to be able to work in those different layers. So now what you want to do is go to File, and you want to click Save As, and then I'm going to save it as Katie Keychain. Oops. And from here, we're going to head over to the WeCreat Make It software. Now, over in our software, all we simply need to do is drag and drop our design into our software. In my Glowforge folder, which I just use as my laser folder, I'm going to go ahead and find my Katie keychain. I'm going to drag it and drop it into that software. Now you'll see that it's come in at the correct size and it looks pretty good, but I always want to zoom in because no matter what I do, for some reason, this always gets a little bit off. No matter how I set it up, I think it's something in the software itself, but you can see that my Katie isn't lined up quite right and my K isn't either. So I'm going to fix my K, and I'm just going to scooch it where it needs to be, and then I'm going to move the Katie around. Now, sometimes you'll have it where it won't let you move it individually, and let me show you how to fix that. So in my settings, a lot of times the auto alignment will be on. I'll turn it back on so that you can see what happens. But when I do that, I'm unable to really move it where I want it to go. See how it won't let me line it up manually? It keeps trying to line it up itself. If you're having that problem, just go into your settings and turn off the auto alignment. That's just to help you. I don't find it helpful, but you know, whatever. And then you just line it up to where it belongs on your screen. Now you'll see that we have three colors. We have the teal, the red, and the black. Each layer is going to be a different function. So I want to engrave both the K and the Katie, but I want to see if by doing it the way I want to do it, which is separately, if maybe it'll work a little bit faster and maybe just come out a little cleaner. So I'm going to select my first layer, which is my black, and I'm going to choose fill engrave. You'll see that it fills in completely. I'm going to choose my K and I'm going to choose fill engrave. And now you'll see that that one turns fully red because that's going to fill in. Then I want to make sure that I choose my blue layer and that layer is going to be cut. Now that will change to red, but that will work separately from the red K layer. So it'll work beautifully. Now I need to plug my laser in and get it ready. I need to put the wood in and we're gonna go ahead and get ready to cut this out. I'll show you exactly how to set it up on to the screen once you have your wood and everything focused and ready to go. So I've turned my laser on and it did its auto or did its refresh where it takes a picture of the wood. So what I want to do is move my design down to this corner. That way I'm not wasting a lot of material. Now again, we've just got all the pieces set to fill engrave or to cut. I just want to make sure that this back section is set to cut. Now that I've got that all set up, all I have to do is choose autofocus. And that's just gonna make sure that everything is where it's supposed to be, where I say it is, and ready to go. You also wanna make sure for this you have laser flat selected and not laser cylindrical. Now that everything is ready to go, you can simply click start. Now this is not gonna start your laser, it's just going to get ready to send it to the laser. You'll see that our estimated processing time is 9 minutes and 16 seconds. I do find that to never be correct, but that's what it says. Now we need to click send to send to the laser and then it will let us press the button on our laser and get started. I'll let you guys go ahead and watch it engrave and cut. We're ready to pull this out. Now I do think I would have made this a little bit smaller and I might cut it again to try it in a smaller size, but I don't mind that it's too big. But I also want you to be aware that this took about 13 minutes and I do need to clean it up a bit from like the burning. I actually like to mask a lot of this type of stuff because it really prevents a lot of the burn, but I think it came out super cool. And like I said, it took about 12 minutes, super easy project that you can do. And now you know how to make one with Inkscape and put it into your Make It WeCreate software. I really think this came out pretty cool. Now, was it faster to engrave the K and the Katie separate? Hard to say, but I do think that it went pretty quickly and it came out really, really nice. If you have any questions, please let me know in those comments down below. And remember, if you're interested in getting a WeCreate Vision, make sure to use code Corinne Blackstone at the link down below to save $100. I really love the machine. I think it's great. The software is easy to use, and I really think the machine has a lot of capabilities. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.